Karnataka, Bangalore. Lalbagh, the most famous amongst the many gardens in Bangalore. The Botanical Garden of Lalbagh stretches around 240 acres in the southern suburbs of Bangalore. It was laid out by Hyder Ali in the year 1760 and was completed by his son Tipu Sultan. The place derives its name from the lovely red roses that bloom here. There are several well laid out terraced lawns and rare tropical and subtropical plants. There are around 1,000 varieties of plants and trees, some of them brought from other countries such as Persia and European countries. Some of the trees are centuries old. Lovely lakes, lotus pools and fountains add to the beauty of the garden. In the center of the garden is a glass house with an intricate crystals in the design of a crystal palace in London, where flower shows are held regularly in months of February and August. An area of different colored plants maintained by HMT in the form of clock with huge dials run by electronic quartz mechanism. Kabban Park. Kabban Park is a landmark lung area of the Bangalore city, located within the heart of the city in central administrative area. Originally created in 1884 when Major General Richard Sansky was the then British Chief Engineer of Mysore State. It was covered an area of 100 acres and subsequent expansion has taken place and the area reported now is about 300 acres. It has a rich recorded history of abandoned flora and fauna plantations coupled with numerous impressive and aesthetically located buildings and statues of famous personages in its precincts. This public park was first named as Maid's Park after Sir John Maid, the acting commissioner of Mysore in 1884 and subsequently renamed as Kabban Park after the longest serving commissioner of the time Sir Mark Cabot to commemorate the silver jubilee of Sri Krishna Raja Vodayar's rule in Mysore. In the year 1927, the park was again renamed as Sir Chamarajendra Park in memory of the 19th century ruler of the state, Sir Chamarajendra Vodayar, in 1868-94, during whose rule the park came into existence. The landscaping in the park creatively integrates natural rock outcrops with the thickets of trees, massive bamboos with grassy expanse and flower beds, and the monuments within its limits, regulated by the Horticulture Department of the Government of Karnataka. The predominantly green area of the park has many motorable roads, and the well-laid-out walking paths running through the park are frequented by early morning walkers and the naturalists who study plants in the tranquil natural environment. Tourists visiting this park in the city of Bangalore have nicknamed the city itself as Garden City. Vidhan Sauda. The Vidhan Sauda, located in Bangalore, is a seat of state legislature of Karnataka. It is an imposing building constructed in the style sometimes described as Neo-Dravidian and incorporates elements of Indo-Saracenic, Rajasthani, Jharkhoja and Dravidian styles. It was built in the 1950s. Shri Kengal Hanumanthayya, Chief Minister of Mysore from 1951 to 1956, is credited with the conception of the Vidhan Sauda. He visited Europe, Russia, United States and other places and got the idea of building Vidhan Sauda by incorporating various designs from the buildings he had seen. The foundation was laid by the then Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, on July 13, 1951. It was completed in 1956. Kengal Hanumanthayya took a lot of interest and effort in building the marvelous granite building. It is also known as the Taj Mahal of South India. The Vidhan Sauda has four floors above and one floor below the ground level and sprawls across the area of 700 by 350 feet. It is the largest legislative building in India. Its eastern face has a porch with 12 granite columns 40 feet tall. Leading to the foyer is the flight of stairs with 45 steps more than 200 feet wide. The central dome, 60 feet in diameter, is crowned by the likeness of the Indian national emblem. The cost of construction at the time was just 17.5 million rupees, but presently annual maintenance cost itself is more than 20 million rupees. The building is illuminated on Sundays and public holidays. Jog Falls. Jog Falls, created by the Sharavati River falling from a height of 829 feet, is the highest plunge waterfall in India, located in Shimoga district of Karnataka state. These segmented falls are the major tourist attraction. It is also called by alternative names of Jirisup Falls, Jirisopa Falls and Jogara Gundi. There are many waterfalls in Asia and also in India which drop from a higher altitude. But unlike those falls, Jog Falls is untiered, that is, it drops directly and does not stream onto rocks. Thus, it can be described as the highest untiered waterfalls in India. Thank you. Nandi Hills. Nandi Hills or Nandi Durg is a hill station situated 1478 meter above sea level and 65 km from Bangalore in Chikkaballapur district of Karnataka. It gets its name from the ancient Nandi or bull, which is meant to be the mount of Lord Shiva. Later developed as Tipu Sultan's summer retreat, this hill station was patronized by the British too. This hill are the source of rivers Palar, Arkavati and Pennar, and rolling green slopes surround the Amrit Sarovar Lake, making it a popular weekend destination. The present grand structure was completed in 1912 at the cost of 42 lakhs. The old palace has been destroyed by fire and the new palace was raised on the model and foundations of the old palace. It is in the Indo-Saracenic style with the use of local materials as far as possible and beautiful domes, archways, turrets, colonnades. The main building is a grey granite structure with 7 arches at the entrance. There are 3 stories topped by a 5-story tower, which is about 145 feet from the ground to the golden flag at the summit. The palace is built around an open courtyard. Only 4 sections are open to the public: Gombe Toti, Kalyana Mandabam, Darbar Hall and Amba Vilas. ground floor is a beautiful Kalyana Mandapam. The octagonal pavilion has a colorful stained glass ceiling with peacock designs and is also known as Peacock Pavilion. On the walls of this pavilion, there are beautiful murals depicting various scenes from the Dasara festival. A total of 26 panels on canvas executed by the Mysore artists commissioned by Krishna Raja Budayar. The Darbar Hall in the first floor is an impressive pillared hall with a wonderful display of paintings by Raja Ravi Verma and 8 forms of Devi executed by artist Shilpi Siddhalinga Swami on rare wall. The paintings of 4 generations of the royal family can be seen on the central panel. The Amma Villas is also in the first floor with wonderfully crafted designs on the doors, walls, ceilings. The royal throne decorated with golden pillars carvings consists of main seat, steps leading to the seat and the golden umbrella. It is on display during the Dasara festival. Chamundi Hills. Chamundi Hill is located about 13 kilometers from Mysore. The shrine to goddess is Chamundeshwari. Tutelary deity of the royal family atop this hill can be reached by a flight of 1000 steps. On the way up, there is a huge monolith Nandi, 16 into 25 feet. There is a giant statue of Mahishasuran, the demon king who was vanquished by goddess Chamundi. Vrindavan Gardens. The well-planned garden was laid at the base of the Krishna Raja Sagar Dam across the river Kaveri. The dam and the garden were built in 1932 during the rule of Krishna Raja Vodayar IV. The gardens were planned by the Raja's Diwan, Sir Mirza Ismail. This is a beautiful picnic spot with its beautiful colorful flower beds, fountains, pools illuminated in the nights.